Hello mga math-tusiast! Welcome back sa ating YouTube channel kung saan ang math ay mas pinadadali at mas minamahal. At andito na naman si Teacher Maria, ang inyong math buddy para tulungan kayo sa mga problema ninyo sa math. And for today's video, ang topic natin ay tungkol pa rin sa measures of positions. Pero bago ko simulan ang video tutorial na ito, siguraduhin na muna ang napindot nyo na dyan ang like button. Sige na mga anak, pindutin na, oh. At syempre, kung bago ka pa lang sa aming YouTube channel, pindutin mo na rin dyan ang subscribe button at i-hit mo na rin ang notification bell para lagi kang maging updated sa mga videos na i-upload ko. Okay na? Na-like, na-subscribe at na-hit na rin ang notification bell? Kung okay na, tara na, simulan na natin. Okay, for this learning task, you have to solve the following problem. So, the ways of the student in a class are the following. We have to calculate quartile 1, quartile 3, and then decile 6 or 6th decile, 45th percentile, and 80th percentile. Okay? Pero lahat yan nagsisimula sa pag-arrange ng values in the distribution in ascending order. So, from the least to the greatest. Okay? Sige, i-arrange natin, ha? Let's start with the lowest. That's 53. Okay? So, 53. Wala na to. Next to 53 is what? 58 na ba? Susunod? Okay, 58. And then, 59. And then, 70. Okay. 70, no. Hindi pa pala 70. Ano muna? We have 59, 62. Okay. Next to 62 is 64. Next to 64 is 67. Dalawa, diba? Okay, dalawang 67. Next is 69. Okay, next is 74. Next to 7. Ah, no, not 74. May 70 and 71. Okay. 69, 70. So, dapat malinaw ang mata. 71. And then 74. And then 76. And then 79. And then 84, and then 89. Ayun yung 9. Oh, wait, nausog natin. Okay, ayan. So, 84, 89. Ilan lahat to? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Kagaya nung sinabi ko dun sa video, i-number nyo, lagyan nyo na ng number tong mga to para mamaya madali na lang sa inyo. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, sakto. Now, okay na tayo sa arrange. Now, number 2, find the position of Q1 using 1 fourth n plus 1 where n is the number of the values and the resulting values must be rounded to the nearest integer. However, if the resulting value falls halfway between two integers, round it up. Okay? So, tingnan natin ha, paano natin to gagawin? So, ang formula natin ay Q1, natatandaan, is equal to 1 over 4 n plus 1. Since our n here is 15, substitute lang natin ito, this will become... Okay, 1 fourth and then, 16, 15, sorry ha, 15 kasi yung n natin ay 15 plus 1. So, you will have 1 over 4, 15 plus 1 is 16. Okay, so 16, 1 times 16 is 16, 16 divided by 4 is 4. So, your Q1 is on the fourth. Now, for number 3, you have to look at the arranged distribution. So, asan ba yung pang 4th? 62. Meaning to say that your Q1, oh, lagay na natin dito. That your Q1 is, ano ulit pang 4th? Sorry, 62, ha? Yung pang 4th data nyo ay 62. Okay. Tama ba yung sinabi ko kanina? I-comment nyo nga. Okay. Now for quartile 3, so arrange the values. Since same given, okay na, na-arrange na natin yan. Yan pa rin yung magiging basis natin. Now let's go to the formula. Dahil third quartile to, ang formula na natin ay magiging eto. So Q3 is equal to 3 over 4 n plus 1. Wherein our n is 15 pa rin, 15 plus 1. Okay, so 3 over 4, 15 plus 1 is how many? 16. Okay, para mabilis ito, we just cancel this one. This is 1, this is 4. 3 times 4 is 12. Ibig sabihin, nasa 12 position siya. Asan ang pang 12? Tingnan nga natin, ang pang 12 natin ay 76. So, dun sa step number 3, so nahanap natin siya, and that is, enter ko lang to, Q3 is 12. Okay, quartile 3 is 12, sorry. Is, ano nangyari kay ma'am? Wait lang ha, wait. Gabi na kasi, madaling araw na. Ano ulit, 76. Ayan. So, tinatapos ko lang ito para bukas i-upload ko na lang. Medyo busy si mami, kaya medyo gabi ko na talaga. Or, medyo umaga ko na ginagawa yung mga videos nyo. Okay, for D6, decile 6. So, arrange the values. Naka-arrange naman na siya. So, no problem na tayo dyan. Now, let's go to step number 2. In finding the position of the... Oh, 6 ito kasi binago ko eh. 6 decile... or D6, use this formula. So, natatandaan pa yung formula natin for D6. So, D6 is equal to 6 over 10, n plus 1. Okay? So, ang n natin is still 15. Okay? So, you will have here 6 over 10, and then this one is 15 plus 1. So, you will have 6 over 10, and this is 16. So, pwede natin itong lowest term. Ito ay magiging 5. Ito naman ay magiging, 8. Tama? Kasi divisible by 2. So, 6 times 8 is 48. Now, divided by 5. Okay? Okay, para mas mabilis, gumamit na tayo ng pinagbabawal na technique. Mag-calculator na tayo, ha? Para hindi na masyadong mahaba tong video. O, divide na natin siya by 5. You'll have 9.6. Now, paano nyo malalaman kung i-round up or i-round down nyo siya? Tingnan nyo yung position ng D6, ha? Okay, tingnan natin ito. Pag nasa center siya, kung ito yung nasa center natin, yung median natin, kapag ang data nyo ay nandito, which is less than our median, you have to round up. Okay? Pero pag nandito siya sa right side ng median natin, you have to round down. Okay? Since D6 is nandito after ng median natin, ang gagawin natin, round down natin siya. So, itong 9.6, magiging 9th na lang siya. So, 9th position yung titingnan natin, ha? Anak, ito ay ibang way or isa pang way ng pagkuha ng decile natin. Kasi yung ginagawa natin last time dun sa week 1 ay linear interpolation, ha? Ito, ginagamit natin si Mendenhall and Sincich ba yun? Okay. So, tignan natin yung 9th natin. Ang 9th natin ay 70. Okay. So, ang ating D6 ay 70. O, ulitin ko ha. Pang 6 niya. Okay. Ang pang 6, D6, which is 9th position, ay 70. Now, let's go to percentile. Arrange. Naka-arrange na siya. Ulit, ha? So, hindi na natin kailangan siyang i-arrange. Now, let's just have the formula to solve for this. So, P45 is equal to 45 over 100 n plus 1. Ito times. So, you will have 45 over 100 times 15 plus 1. And then, you will have... Teka, enter natin. 45 over 100 times 16. 45 over 100 times 16. O, let's see. Okay, at andito na muli siya, 45 times 16. Okay, you'll have 720 divided by 100. So, that's a 7.2. Okay, ngayon, paano natin malalaman? Round up ba or round down? So, kung ito ang median, okay, which is P50, nasan ba si P45? Nasa bago o after? Kasi pag bago, round up. Pero pag after, round down. So, since ang P45 ay nandito, round up tayo. So, ito ay magiging 8. So, pang 8 position yung titingnan natin. Ano yung pang 8 position natin? Ang pang 8 natin ay... Ah, saan? 69. Okay. So, this is... 69. P45 is 69. Okay, now how about P80? So, same naman ang given natin. We just have to solve using the formula for step number 2. Kasi yun pa rin naman yung given natin, di ba? Okay, so we will have here... Oh, hindi ko pa na-edit ito. Wait. Oops. This is 88. This is 88 also. And this is 80. Ayan, para mag-solve kayo, ha? Okay, let's see. If this is P80, you'll have P80 is equal to 80 over 100. And then 16 or 15 or N. Formula muna. N plus 1. Okay, so you will have 80 over 100. Ang n pa rin natin ay 15 plus 1. So you will have 80 over 100. 15 plus 1 is 16. And then let's multiply. Okay, ito na ang shortcut natin. 80 times 16 is 1280. Divided by 100, you'll have 12.8. Okay. So, you will have here 12.8. Dahil ang P80, kung ito ang P50 na median natin, ang P80 ay nandito, ibig sabihin, round down tayo. So, itong 12.8 natin, magiging 12 na lang siya. So, 12 data yung kukunin natin. Ibig sabihin, kapareho nung kanina, di ba may nasolve tayo na pang 12 data? Ano siya? Ang pang 12 natin ay 76. Okay, wait lang ha, baba natin. Ito yung 12 data natin. Di ba may nasolve na tayong 12 data? Tignan ko lang ha. Ayan, tama o, 76. Ayan. So, chinek ko lang. So, P80 is 76. So, ayan mga anak ko, ganyan lang siya. Ha? Sana nag-guide ko kayo dyan sa inyong mga modules kung paano nyo ba sasagutan yung ganitong klase ng problema. Ha? Mga anak ko, sana naman ma-visit nyo naman yung Facebook page natin, Love Ma TV, at makapag-follow kayo. Ha? Inaantay ko kayo dito sa page natin. Ang dami-dami nyo dito sa YouTube, pero sa page, wala man lang mga followers. Kaya sana mabigyan nyo ako ng oras sa puntahan ako dito, okay? At katulad ng lagi kong sinasabi, ang mga comments ninyo ay napakahalaga para ma-upit ang video na ito at makita rin naman ng iba. So, bilang ganti, sana mag-comment kayo dyan sa baba. Kay thank you lang ha, para lang matulungan itong video na ito na makita rin naman ng ibang gustong matutunan yung gantong klase ng problem, okay? At laging tandaan, let's spread the love of math. Thank you and bye!